Good evening, I'm Don Hudson. We begin tonight with an exclusive update to a story that we broke here on ABC 4 News. A Utah representative is now taking action to remove the word slavery from our state's constitution. Yes, slavery still exists as a form of punishment for someone convicted of a crime. ABC 4's Brittany Johnson broke that story. And Brittany, who is this representative who is taking the action?
Well, Don, her name is Sandra Hollins, and she actually knew that this law existed in other states, but she was shocked to find out that it still was on Utah's books. And after our original story did air back in November, she messaged me immediately saying she was going to write a bill to get this removed from Utah's constitution. Now, tonight, I sat down with her exclusively to find out her reasons why. ABC 4 News broke the story last year. Article 1, Section 21 of the Utah Constitution still reads, slavery is forbidden except as a punishment for crime, whereof the party shall have been duly convicted.
When you came out with the story and was like, well, Utah still has this on the books, I was like, oh, wow.
Our story caught the attention of many, including Representative Sandra Hollins. Now, she's taking action.
I'm going to completely remove it.
Representative Hollins says the language of the article is outdated and does not mirror Utah's values.
It doesn't reflect who we are. It doesn't reflect us as Utahns. It doesn't reflect us as Americans. It's a part of a dark past that many of us still don't want to hold conversation about, and it shouldn't be allowed in Utah Constitution, and it shouldn't be in the American Constitution.
For the District 23 representative, tackling this bill has nothing to do with race. It's about doing what's right.
Not all those people who are surprised by or who said that it needs to be removed are not people in African-American culture.
Right now, the bill is in draft form.
This is where I will be introducing the bill.
Then it will need to pass the House and Senate by 2/3 vote this legislative session.
I don't expect to bring everybody on board, but I'm walking forward with those individuals who are willing to walk forward with me.
And if this bill passes the House and Senate, it will then go on to the ballot in 2020, which is the next election cycle. And Don, that means it will be in the hands of Utahns and up to them to decide what side of history they want to be on.